Curare is a common name for various plant extract alkaloid arrow poisons originating from indigenous people in Central and South America. Used as a paralyzing agent for hunting and for therapeutic purposes, curare only becomes active by a direct wound contamination by a poison dart or arrow or via injection. These poisons function by competitively and reversibly inhibiting the nicotinic acetylcholine receptor, which is a subtype of acetylcholine receptor found in the neuromuscular junction. This causes weakness of the skeletal muscles and, when administered in a sufficient dose, eventual death by asphyxiation due to paralysis of the diaphragm. Curare is prepared by boiling the bark of one of the dozens of plant alkaloid sources, leaving a dark, heavy paste that can be applied to arrow or dart heads. Historically, curare has been used as an effective treatment for tetanus or strychnine poisoning and as a paralyzing agent for surgical procedures. The word curare is derived from curare, from the Carib language of the Macusi of Guyana. It has its origins in the Carib phrase mawa cure, meaning of the mawa vine, scientifically known as Strychnos toxifera. Curare is also known among indigenous peoples as Ampi, Wurari, Wurara, Wurali, Oirali, Wuralia, Wurari, Wurare, Wurare, Wurari, and Uirari. Curare was used as a paralyzing poison by many South American indigenous people. Since it was too expensive to be used in warfare, curare was mainly used during hunting. The prey was shot by arrows or blowgun darts dipped in curare, leading to asphyxiation owing to the inability of the victim's respiratory muscles to contract. In particular, the poison was used by the island Caribs, indigenous people of the Lesser Antilles in the Caribbean, on the tips of their arrows. In addition, the Yagua people, indigenous to Colombia and northeastern Peru, commonly use these toxins in their blowpipes to target prey 30 to 40 paces distant. Due to its popularity among the indigenous people as means of paralyzing prey, certain tribes would create monopolies from curare production. Thus, curare became a symbol of wealth among the indigenous populations. Generally, there are dozens of plants from which isoquinoline and indole alkaloids with curarizing effects can be isolated and which were utilized by indigenous tribes of Central and South America for the production of arrow poisons.